Arguably the world's most popular individual sport, tennis enjoys a cult following among the masses across the globe. India, despite being a cricket-centric nation, has a decent following of tennis. The nation has produced Grand Slam champions by the names of Mahesh Bhupathi, Leander Paes, Sania Mirza, and Rohan Bopanna on the professional circuit. However, all these champions have come in the double circuit of the game. The nation struggles to break through on the single circuit. I flew to Chennai, India to discuss the reasons and problems as to why a nation of 1.3 billion people is unable to produce a star singles player. I interviewed one of India's greatest singles players, Somdev Devvarman, who in his prime had a career high ranking of 62 in the ATP World Tour. Since the successes of the Amritraj brothers and Leander Paes, he had been the flag bearer of Indian tennis in recent times. His accolades include winning gold medals at the Commonwealth and Asian Games, numerous decisive wins in Davis Cup ties, and being the only collegiate player to be a three-time finalist at the NCAA Championships, winning it twice at the junior and twice at senior level. Due to his enormous contribution towards Indian tennis, the government of India honored him with India's fourth highest civilian honor, the Padma Shri. When questioned about the current state of Indian tennis, his answer was a cause of concern.
Honest answer?
Totally honest.
I don't think it's in great hands. I don't think Indian tennis is in great hands. And the easiest way to kind of point that out is, for example, my career, right? Or my upbringing, my junior days. I had certain, every junior has difficulties or problems that they face along the way. But the problem with this is, the problems that I faced in, say, 95, 96, 97 are the same problems that exist today. It's the same set of problems. So where's the growth, right? If I didn't have exposure and if I didn't have, and leave the funding, but if I didn't grow up in a system, then I would hope that 20 years from now, the next kid coming up would grow up in a system. There would be a group of players that were pooled together, and there would be coaches looking after them. There would be people managing their careers, figuring out funding for them, or figuring out how they can get stronger, because we keep saying Indians are weak. So that would be a space where I would really focus on, right? But who's done that? And my point is, since we have not done that, and we have the exact same administration in power when I was a junior and now, it's very likely that that's not going to happen in the next 10 years. And that's the reason why I say that Indian tennis is not in great hands.
He stressed that the governing body of tennis, the All India Tennis Association, was largely responsible for the dark phase of Indian tennis. The core problems constituted of a poor administration not being able to execute an organized plan to develop and make the sport more accessible to the common public. The AITA's inability to raise funds and execute a plan which requires those funds were key reasons for the struggles of the sport. Part of the reason why India struggles to craft champions is because we don't have a sporting culture.
Why India doesn't really have a sporting culture? You know, I mean, I've gone to schools here, so have you. And generally in India, you know, I ran into problems where the girls weren't allowed to play with the boys. A lot of people said, don't go play in the sun, you're going to get dark.
Yeah, I'm
not sure if she does, but the point is that there's a lot of unnecessary issues that are there, you know, in Indian sport. Yeah, and you know, and it starts at the grassroots level, at the schools. If the second they need to take a period away, they take away a sports period. So that's telling something to people, even if they don't want to say it. They're saying that, listen, this is the least important subject in school. You know, and what we're really missing over here is not even the champions, man. It's not, yes, we're obviously missing the champions, we should be having more, but we're missing out on the health of an entire nation. You know, you don't, like, what parents need to start understanding, what coaches need to start understanding, is when they send a kid to school, they don't send a kid to school with the sole purpose of winning a Nobel Prize, right? But when you send a kid to a tennis court, he's gonna win Wimbledon, otherwise it sucks.
While India is majorly enjoying success in the double circuit right now, we did have enormous success in the single circuit during the 80s and the 90s. But why did we stop producing single stars at the turn of the century?
So in the 1980s, tennis was really growing. You know, people didn't, Borg, McEnroe, they didn't have coaches. Then coaches started coming around, and once that started, academy started becoming bigger. And so in the 1980s, actually, India made a very nice move. I mean, the Amrit Rajas especially made a very nice move, and you would have to give credit to Mrs. Amrit Raj, because she kind of ran this amazing academy called BAT. Right, yeah. Maggie Amrit Raj, she ran this amazing academy called BAT. And BAT produced players year in and year out, right? Whether it's Leander, whether it's Gaurav Natikal, not Mahesh, Asif Ismail, Karan Rastogi. Mahesh was in the Middle East a little bit, and then he went to college tennis. But the point is that BAT kept producing. Now, that happened in India, right? Now, in the late 80s as well, there was a huge growth in academies in Europe, there was a huge growth of academies in America, and that kind of grew a lot of competition. One led to another, and everybody then wanted to have the best tennis academy. You know, IMG became big, Bolotelli became big. Now, in India, unfortunately, nothing happened. There was BAT and nothing else.
He laid emphasis on the differences of coaching structure in India compared to the rest of the world. While coaches in Europe and America are more open to being questioned by the students, coaches in India feel it's disrespectful to be questioned. He stressed that this culture needs to change if Indian tennis needs to be successful on the single circuit.
First times I went abroad to get coaching was when I was 19 in the University of Virginia. And the most amazing thing I noticed over there, and this was really hit me hard, is I had three coaches, and every single one of them wanted to learn. You know, and never once in India did I feel like I was around coaches who said, wow, that technique looks amazing, we should try it out. It was always they knew the right answer, and there was no talking back. I mean, think of your PT master.
Exactly.
Right? I mean,
I think it's the culture in general.
That's the culture, right?
The students
and unfortunately, you know, we don't have a very healthy culture of question and answers between students and their coaches. You know, when I was a kid, it almost felt disrespectful if I went up to my coach and asked him a question because I kind of, you know, didn't really agree with what he said. In the States, that was the most normal thing for me. You know, so I felt like the coaches over here were so tied down to having discipline in a camp and having the student kind of look up to him and respect him that they forgot in the process that sport always evolves. And in order to stay with it, you need to evolve as a coach as well. A player needs to evolve, the coach also needs to evolve, the system needs to evolve. Everything needs to constantly get better. That's the world of sport. And if you're not going to do that, you're going to get left behind. So that's the problem, right? Indian coaches have had a huge ego. This is not just in tennis. This is across the board. If people are watching this and they can even think of a few coaching situations that they've had growing up, you would probably have dealt with a coach that had a massive ego who you could not question. Now, my point with all of this is you should always be open to growing, and you should always feel like you can be learning as a coach, because principally that's what you're trying to teach your kid. And if you're telling a kid you have to be open to be learning, as a coach you also have to be open to be learning, otherwise that's massively hypocritical. And every coach that I ever worked with who I felt was world class or had world class results has always been open to learning, and I don't see that in India.
While India does have ITA, it does not have proper management to look after the tennis structure. Another option could have been to privatize ITA, just like the BCCI did for cricket in India. But is privatizing a struggling sport the answer?
Why would Tata or Reliance invest? The same leadership that has proven to be unsuccessful in 95 or 85 is still running the body. Why would you invest in something that has proven to fail?
Either you just shut the body and bring a new one.
No, so the only way we can be successful is if the right people with the right motivations and the right knowledge are in the right places. So when you're looking at higher, absolutely. When you're looking at upper management, you have to have a lot of knowledge about what you're doing, which means you really need to know the sport, you need to know how to grow it, you need to have a business sense as well. But what generally breeds success is a motivation to be successful. So that person sitting on top has to A, have a lot of knowledge, and B, have a lot of motivation. My understanding of Indian sport tennis in particular, is the people sitting on top do lack knowledge because they have not been around the tour, and they lack motivation in order to make it great. So what are you going to get? You're going to get a very, very crappy product, and that's what Indian tennis has become. So in order for us to change, we need to change leadership. And the leader needs to have, from the grassroots level, the leader needs to know exactly what it takes and be very, very motivated to make sure that his plan succeeds. Why? Listen, this is not something that should be new or controversial. This is how every successful business operates.
Somdev is one of the few people who understands what needs to be done to improve the state of Indian tennis. Being one of the most successful players India has produced, he's taken up the responsibility of mentoring a future prospect from India, Dakshineshwar Suresh. He is a 3 times winner in singles on the national circuit in India. He gave his views on the current status of Indian tennis and his future ambitions.
What is the state of Indian tennis at the moment, according to you? Your personal opinion?
These guys are working hard, but it's tough to break through inside the top 100. There's only like one guy inside the UK. You need to work, like go abroad and practice, or you need to have a good coach, good focus, and you know, you have to train with the guy who knows what to do with you, and then that's the thing, only thing you can do.
Why is it that we have been successful in the double circuit of the game and we haven't been able to replicate that in the single circuit?
No, it's obviously it's something else, I think, so, because players are good in volleys from India, but they're not good enough on the back. You need to be more endurance should be, like, you have to get the more stamina inside the court. Singles is a lot tough because you have to move so much, and then you have to be, you're the only guy we're playing, you're not, like, there's not 2 guys inside the court. In doubles you can just play easy because that it's 2 guys, and then the point just finish in like 2-3 balls. But in singles it's not like that. You need to move more, and the other guys are especially like good in endurance and stuff. Indians are not that good. You need to improve on that to make it in the singles. Like throwing here in India, it's really tough because the guys are not gonna support you that good. Because in abroad they're really focused on it to make the players good. That's why I went to Spain last year in Barcelona first time academy. I really improved there, and then when I came back I won the nationals right there. And you know, there are good players, good coaches who really look on to it. But in India they act like they do, but it's not really happening. That's why there's not many players coming there. I want to be in the, like, you know, the top 500 at least, make it by the next year. But I want to be in the really top level, like in the top 50 by whenever I can. 2-3 years maybe. I'll have to like work so hard for it. It's not easy.
Post retirement, Somdev has been working along with his friend Vikram towards grooming stars of tomorrow. Together they set up an NGO called Life is a Ball, which gives an opportunity to underprivileged kids from a grassroots level in the hopes of creating a sporting culture in India.
Hey guys, my name is Vikram, co-founder of Life is a Ball. What we do is we organize a weekend sports event for the public to come in and participate to help raise funds for Life is a Ball. What Life is a Ball does is we basically provide quality physical education and sports solutions for underprivileged kids, something we started 6 years back now, and we've touched around 17,000 kids as of today.
While Indian tennis is still struggling to break through in the single circuit, we do have promising stars in Ankita Raina and Prajnesh Gunneswaran. They recently competed at the 2018 Asian Games and set new standards for tennis in India by winning bronze in the single circuit.